Mode 3 turns Civilization into a 4-channel CV step recorder. We call it a quad mucorder because you can mutate the recordings. Each of the 4 tracks can have up to 16 steps with CV values, which you can overdub or erase on the fly. Once recorded, there are 4 different ways you can mutate your sequences, from subtle right up to beyond recognition in real time. These mutations are random changes that build up over time. You can activate quantization to make sure these mutations always remain in scale. Clock division and glide are also available individually for all 4 tracks. Mode 3 also lets you transpose your sequences with a keyboard or any other control voltage. Now, let's start exploring Mode 3 by recording an 8-step sequence on track 1. We'll be using a keyboard with gate and CV outputs. We'll connect the keyboard's gate output with Civilization's CVA input, providing the trigger signal. The pitch output of the keyboard is hooked up with input 1. With nothing recorded yet, we're now monitoring the input signal. On the performance page, pressing the first left-hand encoder will arm the first track for recording. We can now input a sequence with our keyboard. With each gate signal, the sequencer advances by 1 step. When you're done, simply press the left encoder to stop recording. You can also specify the number of steps before recording, using the left encoder, from 2 up to 16. Recording will then stop automatically once the set number of steps has been reached. Okay, now that we have recorded our sequence, let's play it back. As you can hear, it's running in a loop. This is how many traditional step sequences work. For example, the one on the Roland SH-101. The LED brightness indicates the progress of the sequence. If you want to transpose your sequence, turn the left-hand encoder 1 tick to the right. The LED will light up turquoise. Now, you can shift the sequence with your keyboard. So far, so good. But didn't we mention we can mutate our sequence? To accomplish that, simply turn the right-hand encoder clockwise. With each tick to the right, the likelihood and intensity of the mutation increases. To give you visual feedback, the LED will turn a brighter blue. Watch as the mutation builds up over time, widening the intervals between the recorded notes. Turning the encoder left from the zero position will narrow the intervals, with the LED turning a ruby color. Turn the encoder to the zero position or press it to freeze the current mutation. Push the right-hand encoder again to revert the sequence to its original recorded state. Or, if you like the mutated sequence, save it by long pressing the right-hand encoder and make it the new original. Pressing the left and right-hand encoder together will erase the sequence. Now we're hearing the straight input signal again. Let's create another sequence, this time with 16 steps, all with the same pitch. We'll now carefully dial in the mutation and listen to the gradual changes. Instant Berlin School. Experiment with different sequence lengths for different results. Next, let's explore a very handy feature of Mode 3, the ability to overdub a recording. This means that you can record on top of an existing sequence on the fly. For simplicity, let's take a 16-step sequence with the same pitch on all steps. Clocking is provided by an LFO. Let's go to Config page 2 and set up the CVB input to toggle the overdub function for track 1. Now, whenever a keyboard's gate signal is present at the CVB input, the current step will be overwritten with the input 1 signal. Here we have our one note sequence. Boring, huh? Okay, let's breathe some life into it. You can now punch in your notes on the fly in real time while the sequencer is running in a loop for as long or as often as you'd like. Another really cool feature of Mode 3 is that you can manipulate a live signal with Civilization's mutation algorithms. Take an analog step sequencer and connect its CV output with input 4. Next, we'll patch a steady CV signal from the pressure points module into the input of track 3. For track 4, we're setting the quantization scale to green, which is natural minor, and the mutation type to blue, which is randomly copy from the track above. Now, once we start adding the mutation, values from track 3 will be randomly copied into track 4. We're effectively shuffling signals from both tracks together. Listen as we tweak the pressure point's CV knob to change the pitch of the mutated steps. As you can see, not only can you mutate a recorded sequence, but also a live signal. Let's create a two-voice patch with two tracks playing at the same time. We'll let track 2 copy notes over from track 1. Starting off, track 1 is playing a 16-step sequence. For track 2, we've recorded a 15-step sequence with the root note of the first sequence and tuned it down by an octave. This is going to be our bass. Again, we need to set the mutation type to blue for track 2. We're now hearing track 1 on the left side of our stereo mix. Let's bring in track 2 on the right. The way it sounds now, track 2 is playing the root note only. We'll now dial in the mutation on track 2, so it will randomly copy notes from track 1. As you can hear, more and more notes appear on the right that have been copied over from the left. Having 15 steps on track 2 versus 16 steps on track 1 gives us a nice polyrhythmical pattern. Far out, man. To thin our bass sequence out, we can decrease the mutation by turning the encoder to the left, into the negative values. Now, the root note starts to appear more often. Remember, quantization, clock division, glide, and sequencer reset are always available individually on all four tracks as well. So much for Mode 3. Watch our other videos dealing with modes 1, 2, and 4, along with more useful tutorials and demos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and see you next time.